Hi, this is Brea from ClickTime, answering your most pressing questions about the ClickTime platform. Today, we received the following inquiry. Hi, support. How can we set up accrued vacation or sick hours for an employee based on a certain date, like their start date? This is a great question and one we get asked often. Now, before we get started, there are a few things to be aware of. First, what are time off accruals? Well, you can think of accruals as a way to automatically add hours to an employee's time off balance each month. For example, our organization allows us to give 8 hours of vacation to each employee every month. Next, accruals can be set up for any employee and any leave type in ClickTime. Different leave types can accrue at different rates and for different employees. For example, you can award 8 hours of vacation and 4 hours of sick time each month to one staffer and more or less to another. ClickTime uses a 30-day accrual model, meaning that users start accruing hours on a particular date of a month and complete that accrual 30 days later. Accruals are awarded in arrears, meaning that hours are awarded after the previous accrual period has been completed. Even with time off balances accruing automatically, you can still manually adjust balances separately as needed. And you can use your company's HRIS system, like BambooHR or HiBob, to manage accruals and integrate the data directly with ClickTime. Now that you know the basics, let's dive into the platform. Before we can set up accruals for an employee, we want to first approve any pending timesheets or time off requests so that these don't conflict with the changes we're making. Next, let's walk through each option in the accruals panel. The accrual rate field tells the system how many hours to give the employee each month. This amount can be updated at any time. As a reminder, accruals are awarded in arrears. The accrual start date field establishes a date when the accrued hours will be added to the employee's balance each month. This can be any date between the 1st and the 28th of any month. If you ever need to make a manual adjustment to an employee's time off balance, you can use the Modify Balance option, which will allow you to either add or subtract hours per a certain date with any notes included. The details of this will be added to the employee's balance table chronologically. And lastly, there's the Max Accrual field, which allows you to set a threshold of hours so that when the system accrual reaches this cap, it will no longer accrue hours for this employee's leave type. This is helpful in cases where an organization may have a limit on certain time off hours per month or per year. Once accruals are active, this is how the accrued hours will appear at the completion of each accrual period. So that's it. We hope you enjoyed this brief overview of ClickTime's time off accrual capabilities. Since we only covered the basics, if you'd like more information, click the link in the video description below to access our in-depth help article or email us at support@clicktime.com.